my name is Matt Carter, and you tune in to episode number 67 of the show right here on Shaw TV. All right, our musical guests are right in behind us right now. It's Mr. Mark Christinger. He's a singer-songwriter who's living here in Nanaimo, but he's actually lived, traveled, and played all across this glorious nation of ours. He was back with us back in episode number 22, so I'm stoked to hear what's new with him, hear some more music, and he'll also have an interview with Mr. Matthew Hoffman, not to be confused with Jimmy Hoffa, who's out for a swim, are you, bud? Yes, Matthew Hoffman will talk to Mark later on this hour. Now, if you've ever played poker with me, you'll know that I'm really good at folding. However, when it comes to paper, I'm really horrible at folding, so I'm really glad that Joni has brought in an origami expert, Shino Yoneda, to tell us a little bit about origami. Now, on a very, very serious note, one of the most tragic things that can ever happen to a family is the loss of a child. And you think, well, this won't happen to my family, but actually happened to a good friend of mine up in Parksville not that long ago. So Kim's got a great segment for us. She's introduced us to a group called Compassionate Friends. It's an organization that supports families after such a loss. Representing the group and speaking with Kim will be Scott Whitney and Gwen Linsky-Dolmage. We're going to continue on with our New Year's resolution involving getting fit with a bit of a twist here. Kim's going to speak with Raven Pruden. He's a fitness trainer who's also very well accomplished in jiu-jitsu and self-defense training. And considering the amount of fans of the show I have to fight away every time I go get groceries, I might have to sign up for a class myself. Who am I kidding? They just tell me I move around way too much. What a load of crap. Anyways, we're also happy to welcome Shalima Gant back to the Shaw TV studios. She'll be speaking with Joni about what's going on with the Nanaimo African Heritage Society and how they're recognizing Black History Month. And the rumor on the street is we may have a surprise musical performance to go along with that. But first, we're going to meet a comedy duo who are much more acclaimed and much better dressed than clock stars Todd Jones and Derek Johnstone, if you can even believe it. Find out who it is next. Keep on watching. It's the show right here on Shaw TV.
I'm so excited. Today we're joined by royalty. Hello, drama queens.
Hello.
Hello. This is Erin Ormond, and this is my lovely Lanceville friend, Nicolle Nattrass. And they're kind of wacky, crazy, creative actresses who've come up with this duo called the drama queens. Mm-hmm. Welcome, welcome, my drama queens.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
I like the glasses.
Thank you. Yeah, a little sparkle goes a long way.
I see. Yeah. So, can you explain the drama queens?
Well, the drama queens... started with Nicolle, but they are two characters, two women. Shiki, played by Nicolle, and Trixie, played by myself. Yeah. They are self-proclaimed celebrity superstars turned self-help gurus.
At least in their own minds.
Yes, right. Who travel around basically helping to encourage people to bring out their own inner drama queen.
And to shift their boring, dull lives, you know, into something better.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. I need you.
Yes. Everyone does, really. That's why we're here.
We're finding out.
So, Nicolle, you wrote this.
I did.
How did you come up with the drama queens?
Just from, fantasizing about what it would be like to be a celebrity. maybe it's from personal experience from working with a few interesting people. Not you, of course. some divas, maybe. And just really... playing around with this idea of what it would be like to meet a real live drama queen. And two of them being best friends who are in competition constantly with each other.
That's right.
For attention.
You two are. Okay, so how did you two find each other?
We can't talk about it. It's top secret.
See, I knew about her, but she didn't know about me.
No, I wasn't interested. But we met through a mutual friend.
Yeah.
That's all we can say. All.
And it was destiny.
Yeah.
Destiny? That's so beautiful.
Yeah. And she's quite tall and I'm shorter, so it worked out well.
Really well.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, Nicolle, how are the drama queens like you and not like you?
They're totally different from me. I'm a mom.
Nothing like Nicolle.
Yeah, I'm a mom. I work as an actor. I'm always very conscientious as an actor. So they're not. She's nothing like me at all. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You?
Yes, it's a big jump, but. You know, as an actor, you have to dig deep and you have to use your imagination and we found it.
We know a lot, so we draw upon our own wisdom.
Okay, self-help girls. Okay, so what's exciting? This is what I'm really excited about. I'm excited that you're here, but I'm also really excited about your new TV show.
We are too.
We are, yeah.
We're very, very, very fortunate. We were cast in a new TV show called She Kills Me. Great title. Mm-hmm. It's on APTN TV.
Right.
And we're in an episode on February 19th, mm-hmm. which is really, really great. And it's actually 14 minutes. I wrote originally 28 minutes for the show. We shot it in front of a live audience, two live audiences, in Victoria on February 13th last year. So it's coming out.
Mm-hmm. So a whole year. And what's really exciting about that, She Kills Me, is a whole group of female comics, and it's sort of episodes of different comics, and you guys are one of the featured ones. And you're working on another full-length show on your own, aren't you? Is
That's
that what
right.
you're trying
we're,
to pitch?
We're going to be having our own talk show, and we're in talks with Steven Spielberg right now.
Yeah.
Well, actually, someone more local than Steven, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, 6 degrees of separation.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, and what station is She Kills Me going to be on?
APTN TV.
Yeah.
February 19th, Wednesday.
At 9:30.
9:30. Yeah. Okay. So that's
for Islanders.
So you're going to have a gala night to watch? Or?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, we'll do the red carpet thing for sure.
For sure.
Yeah.
In Lansville. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. See that happen.
Yeah. Yeah. At the general store, maybe. I don't know. Yeah.
Castle Darrell sausages, we're good to go. And you're from Chemainus, right?
Yes.
That's
yeah.
Right. So, and you both are big actors in the community. You do a lot of acting. I know you do auditions. Mm-hmm. How is being an actress or an actor here on the island?
Well, it can be tough, but you know, I think like Nicolle, and you know, you write your own stuff, you create your own work is often the way to go, and it's not unlike how it works, I think, in Vancouver and Toronto mm-hmm. as well. If you're not working, then you try and create your own work. But also, I also teach voice and speech. Sometimes I teach down at the University of Victoria in their theater department, or teach right. workshops
because
here and there.
Busy.
I
both.
Teach
so
at you find her, in yeah. town yeah. as well.
So busy so, actors and stuff. Yeah. Well, I'm so excited about the Drama Queens, and I'm so pleased that you're here. And I think
Thank you.
Might just have to have you back on and be a little more sparkled up.
Yeah, yeah. We'd love to come back.
I bet you
love
would.
Love to do something from the show.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to head over, and I love hearing about the success stories, but we're going to head over and we're going to learn a little bit more about origami. Do you guys like origami, your
oh,
drama
definitely,
queens?
Definitely, yeah, I love
like
it.
Sparkly origami,
yeah.
I bet.
Yeah. Yeah, glitter.
Yeah, well, we're going to head over to Joni. Have fun.
Sparkly origami. We've gone from drama queens to the origami queen. We're here with Shino Yoneda.
Yoneda.
I knew I was going to get that wrong. So then I got it wrong. Anyway, so that now we've got that out of the way, but you are the queen of origami. And we've got all of the various things here that you've brought with you to show people how to do origami. But first of all, we're going to talk a little bit about your background and how you got into this, because you were born in Kyoto.
Yes, I was born in Kyoto in Japan, and I moved over here in 1995. Mm-hmm. And I was a teacher in Japan, and I've been doing translation and other stuff, but I was start to think what I could do, something with touch of Japan.
Right, and because your husband brought you over here.
Yes.
Then, you know, what do you do when you're here? You bring all of the things that you're used to. So mm-hmm. tell me what you've got with you. There's an abacus here.
Yes, this is the abacus, and in Japanese it's called soroban, mm-hmm. and I own Soroban Communication and Education. It's a small business and educational support business, and including using abacus, which is manipulative, mm-hmm. and introducing origami and Chinese brush writing.
Right, and
yes.
these are both traditionally Chinese or Japanese
yes.
Things that kids would do when they're growing up. And
yes.
I love the idea that you've translated that into sort of the math concepts
yes.
Behind origami.
Thank you very
as
much.
Well.
Yes, my goal is to introduce different way to numeracy and arithmetic.
Right.
And origami is traditional. Traditionally kind of girl's craft, that's many people still think like that.
Mm-hmm.
But behind it,
there's a lot of math.
Yeah, this is a little must, and this is a crane.
Mm-hmm.
It's a kind of complicated figure. But
well,
once we unfold, mm-hmm. you will see lots of crease,
right, so
and you see the patterns.
We'll show that to the camera
and
here.
You could see geometry.
Right.
And
it's amazing that that becomes that.
Yes, and
yes.
a lot of mathematicians and physicians, scientists, started to look into this.
Right.
And the modern these days, they put information and create crease first in computer to fold something very realistic and complicated.
And you were saying that using solid paper colors is a great way to do it because you can see the folds.
Yes.
We've got things here that are amazing. This is your cranes, your thousand cranes. You were talking about what that would be used for.
This is used for to show the gesture of compassion and also believing somebody who's recovery, who's in very hard condition and so forth.
Oh, that's great. And so we've got three-dimensional designs. We've got this, it's like a little seashell.
Yes.
But today we're actually going to be thinking about Valentine's Day.
Yes.
We've got hearts. Can you show us some of the cards over there that you've got?
These are the hearts we are going to fold right now.
Okay.
Since Valentine's Day is very close.
Usually I just fold the card, but actually we're going to fold the hearts that go onto the card as well. So now there's lots of different ways to use these hearts.
Yes.
And so we're going to actually be coming back and doing the hearts themselves. Mm-hmm. But you're using a certain type of paper. What kind of paper would be best?
These are origami I got from local craft store.
Mm-hmm.
And also they, or you will find beautiful kind of patterned ones.
Nice.
But for the people who just start, I recommend solid color ones.
Right.
So that easy to see crease to follow.
Great. Yeah. Well, that's, it's, I mean, it's amazing. You've got all the colors, you've got all the different textures, and so we're going to be able to make all sorts of different hearts so that we can make our own Valentine's Day cards. And so, again, you got some of these in Japan, so you don't have to go all the way to Japan to pick up your paper.
That's right.
But you want to work with something that's able to be folded. We don't want to be working with cardboard or anything.
Mm-hmm. Any kind of,
you're making a lot of
wrapping
folds.
Paper and so forth?
Wrapping paper. That's a good idea too. So you've got all sorts of different you know, colors and textures and things, and then
patterns.
And so yeah, basically we're going to be looking at making this heart here, aren't we?
And later on, yes, we will.
Because I'm always fascinated with how that piece of paper can become a heart or anything. I mean, it's amazing what you've got here.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do is we're going to throw over to Kim, and speaking of compassion, we're going to be thinking about the cranes, and we're going to be going back to Kim, who's going to be talking about compassion.
Well, this is a very hard story for me to do, and for many people to hear, and the loss of a child is something that I can't fathom, I can't imagine going through that. But today we're joined by Gwen Linsky and Scott Whipney, and they've suffered loss of children. And Scott and I met when I was helping with a fundraiser when he lost his two stepsons in a tragic fire 2 years ago. And it's still, it's just been the anniversary. Anyway, it's very sad, but I'm so thankful both of you are here because this is a really important topic we talk about. Talking about grief and how we deal with it and how we continue to live is very important. So Gwen, can you tell me a little bit about Compassionate Friends of Canada?
Oh, I'd love to. The Compassionate Friends of Canada is an international organization for parents who've had children die. And I've been on the national board for a number of years. And we develop chapters all across Canada.
Right.
And we're all volunteer based and try to do our best to help parents.
So this is a hard question. How did you get involved with Compassionate Friends?
Well, it's an organization that nobody wants to belong to, that's for sure. And but my story is actually 42 years old this coming March. We lost both of our children in a gas explosion back in March 1972. Robbie was 4 and the baby was 8 days old.
Oh, lovely.
And at that time there wasn't any support, there wasn't any books to read, there wasn't any self-help groups, there just wasn't anything. You just needed to get on with
right.
it. And so it was 15 years later after the death of our children that I found out that Compassionate Friends was coming to our town in southern Manitoba. And I thought I'd go and maybe lick an envelope or make coffee or something, and that's been 27 years.
Wow.
I've been doing it for 27 years now. Yeah.
Scott, how has Compassionate Friends helped you with the loss of your stepboys?
It's given me a safe place to grieve. It's given me a whole new family that understands what we go through and how we're feeling.
Right. I know Gwen says she's kind of like your mom right now.
Yes.
I think that's a beautiful thing for both of you. Yeah. Anyway, I am so sorry for your losses. Gwen, you have an event coming up. Can you tell me a little bit about the event?
Yes, I'd love to. This sort of just came about. I have a friend of mine that is going to be the keynote speaker at the Guns and Gang Awareness, Gangs and Gun Symposium in Vancouver. And he's from Winnipeg. And I said, hey, you know, we've got to have you on the island because he's helped so many young kids. And this is drug awareness. So he said, yeah, he would come over, you know. And he's here, he's coming, and he's going to, this whole event has snowballed. We call it, it's a two-tier, and the first part of it is Choices.
Right.
And that is on February 26th, just for the kids, and then in the evening, it's for the whole community.
And that one's Drugs Are Killing Our Kids Community Open Mic Forum, correct?
That's right.
Lots of great community members.
Right.
So, Scott, what will people learn at this event? What will people take away?
Awareness of what's happening on the streets.
Mm-hmm. You know, and that's important here in Nanaimo and Parksville and Ladysmith, all around,
yes.
Isn't it?
It's huge. There's so many people dying in Nanaimo from drugs.
Yeah, absolutely. We got some great people. So I want to get something in quickly. Compassionate Friends supports the community. What can us, as a community, do to support you? What can we do?
What can you do? Our greatest need right at the moment and most crucial need is to have financial support.
Right.
We need to be able to buy, you know, books like this, you know, videos, do our brochures, anything to help us.
Well, I really thank Gwen and Scott. And Scott, anyway, I thank you and I'm thankful for your stories, and I really believe that you guys are here to help, and if anyone needs you, Compassionate Friends is here all across Canada and the United States. So we're going to go back over to Origami and we'll find some peace in that too.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, and I'm back with Shino, and we're talking about Origami, and there's the tie-in. We've got these lovely cranes here that are all a part of compassion, and also hearts are part of compassion, and so we're actually going to create a heart. You're going to try to show me how to do this.
Yes, I will, and this is a little kind of instruction here.
Yes.
But so, Joni.
Okay.
So let's start with, we need color, that last part, so let's start with white side up.
Okay.
And fold it in half.
Fold it in half, okay.
Make a triangle.
Mm-hmm. And you can just keep going if I stand behind.
And then fold it again to make a smaller triangle.
Okay. And don't have any of the white joints.
Okay. And please open it up.
I'm going to open it up. And you teach this at schools, don't you, and at the museum?
Yes. On the top one, here's the center. So the top corner, please fold it down to the center like that.
Do you find kids easier to teach than adults?
Interesting question, yes.
Probably.
And this side, the bottom big triangle, we will fold this tip all the way up.
Oh, all the way up. See, now I already mucked that up.
And we are at number 4.
Okay.
Okay. And here's the center line.
Yes.
And we will bring this right hand one.
Oh, the right hand one.
Yeah.
Okay,
right
totally
up
dyslexic.
All the way up there. So the bottom part, this line will meet the center line.
Okay, good.
And we will repeat the same thing, left hand side.
Nice, and supposedly they will meet nicely, but mine didn't quite meet as nicely as yours. But hey, that's
almost
great.
There. Mm-hmm. So please turn it over. We are going to make a little bit of adjustment here. Fold both sides a little bit.
In. Okay.
And both kind of top pieces, fold those
so
down.
So you can just do it at whatever point you want to.
Yeah,
those are beautiful.
Origami.
That's great. Look, I made a heart. That's
you great. Did. It's so, very simple.
Again, you teach at the art gallery,
through Nanaimo Art Gallery
and District 69, and you have all sorts of different things that you're offering
yes,
to various
do.
Age groups. And so, if people want to make and you've got heart
different
here, but you've
it's
also
very
got
simple one.
As you say, if you do them in a different color
or different shapes,
St. Patrick's
like
Day.
The whole one, then quarter and 1/8, yeah.
Well, that's great. So if people want to find out more, they can actually go to your site. Everything's on the screen, and they can find out more. Thank you so much for
Thank
showing
you.
Me how
Thank
to do this.
You're welcome.
And now we're going to be listening to a song, and we're going to be handing it over to Mark.
My heart calling, I can see that I am falling for a dream that may not come to pass. Is this red sky a simple warning, rising high on Monday morning? You better slow down, you don't want to move too fast. I don't wanna be the one whose light shines then shatters. I don't wanna be the one whose heart gets bruised and battered. But this could be the one to change my life and really matter now. Now, yeah. We've been talking round in riddles, now we're caught up in the middle of talking trash and telling tales of trouble. We can wonder, we can wallow, or have some faith in tomorrow and shed all fears and don't be afraid to stumble. I don't wanna be the one whose light shines then shatters. I don't wanna be the one whose heart gets bruised and battered. But this could be the one to change my life and really matter now. Now. Now, you know I've had some romances, I'm still trying to get it right. Hey, you've got to take a few chances, love is the wind that lets us all take flight. I can hear my heart calling, I can see that I'm falling. It's time to throw my fears into the wind. I don't wanna be the one whose light shines then shatters. I don't wanna be the one whose heart gets bruised and battered. But this could be the one to change my life and really matter now, yeah. I don't wanna be the one whose light shines and shatters. I don't wanna be the one whose heart gets bruised and battered. but this could be the one to change my life and really matter now. Now, yeah.
All right, that is Mr. Mark Christinger with the song The One. Mark, great to have you back on the show.
It's good to be back.
Good, good to have you here. We'll get an interview with you later on, but I do want to ask you real quickly, tell us a bit about that song, The One.
Yeah, The One, a song about being cautiously optimistic when entering into a new relationship.
Not too shabby. All right, good stuff. Again, thanks so much for being on the show. We'll talk with Matthew a bit later on. I also really enjoyed sort of the Sultan of Swing, Mark Knopfler, like in the solo
Thank
there.
Thank you, man.
Picked up on that one, yeah. Great stuff. All right, so again, you are watching the show right here on Shaw TV. And what can I tell you what we've seen already? Well, we met the drama queens earlier on, not to be confused with the dairy queens who were supposed to be here, but they were caught in a blizzard. So, yeah, we couldn't have the dairy queens there. Yeah, That's the best I got, Todd's asking me. Anyways, come on, keeping it serious. We also learned about Compassionate Friends, a very, very poignant segment. So great job with Kim and her guests for that. A wonderful group there, again, helping families move on and facilitate moving steps forward after a loss of a young child in a family. We also dove into Origami with the Origami Queen. And I know now that Joni will probably be getting me a paper crane, I'm assuming, for the next Christmas. So nice job with Joni for that. And still coming up, in addition to our interview and more music with Mark Christinger, we're going to see what's going on with the Nanaimo African Heritage Society, including what they got going on to recognize Black History Month, and that is in the month of February. A quick note about that, Black History Month was recognized in Canada back in the 90s after a motion was put forward in the House of Commons by Jean Augustine. She was an Ontario Liberal who was actually the first African-Canadian woman elected to Parliament. That was back in the 1993 federal election, so great ties there. And as part of that segment, we also, we're on the street, is we're going to have a surprise hip-hop show, a little show song as well. But coming up next, I'm going to throw it back over to Kim, who has got a bit of a segment on self-defense. So, Kim, let's throw it over to you.
Thanks, Matt. Your jokes are good. Good. Yeah. Anyway, we're going to talk a little, something else a little bit sad that's going on in the news of late is that we're hearing more assaults and stalking situations. Sadly, it's happening in our town as well as the big cities. And the goal here today is to give some more techniques and information for personal safety. And I'm joined today by Raven Pruden, and he's with Parksville's Engage Fitness. And you're also part of Rotary and everything in Parksville. Quite honestly, he's the guy. He does a variety of self-defense classes, and you will be our guide today. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How
good.
Are you, Kim?
I'm good. I'm glad you're here. I'm really thankful you're here, actually. So why is personal self-defense important?
Well, it's important for a lot of reasons, most of it personal safety,
yeah.
Of course,
yeah.
Your survival.
Right. So with what's happening out there, well, actually, I want to know, how did you get into teaching this? Because you have quite the background.
You know, it's kind of an interesting little twist around of things, and I don't think I really picked it, it picked me. Mm-hmm. So being a small person as I grew up, I was bullied and picked on quite a bit. So as I got older, this continued to happen. Mm-hmm. And I took a career fronting a band. So I worked in bars a lot. Mm-hmm. And as you can imagine, there's a lot of violence in bars.
Really?
I don't know how that happens. So I started learning self-defense arts.
Okay.
I went through boxing. It didn't quite work for me. I got beat up a lot. I tried a little bit of Taekwondo. It didn't work out for me. I got beat up a lot. And then I started doing jiu-jitsu.
Right.
And right from the first class, it stopped. I haven't been beat up since I started learning jiu-jitsu. And that was 25 years ago.
Very good. So when you're doing your self-defense classes, because you do a lot and they're from all ages, is that right?
Yes.
So when you're, like, you have got kids and you do seniors as well?
I do. Yeah. Everybody.
Everybody needs self-defense.
We're all at risk.
Sadly, that's the truth. So what are the main things that people want to learn when they come to you?
Well, everybody wants to know the big stuff. You know, they want to be able to throw somebody and punch them or break their arm or the knee in the private parts is usually a big one that's thrown out there.
Right. You know. But that's not really what you want people to do. There's other techniques and ideas that you want people to take away.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And there's where the key is. Awareness. That's really your first weapon. Mm-hmm. We like to think of it as a toolbox, as you're learning techniques that you take a little tool and you put it in your toolbox.
Right.
So you have something for every situation that comes up.
Right.
And not every technique that you know is going to work for certain situations. So you want to learn a lot of them eventually.
Right.
But if you don't have that right away, you want to know some survival techniques. And the first one you can do is simply be aware, to keep your head up, to look around, and to know what your environment's like.
Right. So taking your earbuds out?
A little bit, or maybe just one.
Right.
I mean, you know, you're still living your life, but if your earbuds are in, open your eyes.
Right.
Okay. You've got to use your other senses as
well. Okay, perfect. Okay. So you're going to, one of the words that you use is trapping.
Yes.
Okay. Explain trapping. I mean, you're going to show demonstrate trapping.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Trapping's a quick technique. So if you don't have a lot of skill or you don't have techniques or background like mine, the first thing you want to do is kind of prevent the attack from being a large attack or being damageful. So if I were to grab you, if I wanted to take you somewhere or I just wanted to get a hold of you, what you would want to do is put your hand on mine and press it against you, and that is trapping. It's that simple. And it works. It doesn't matter where I grab from here. What this does is it stops me from getting my hand back. So now I only have one hand to use. So if I was going to strike you, it's going to be that one. It takes a lot of guesswork out of it for you. Mm-hmm. You know this one's coming.
Yeah.
So you can duck and move away from this one while you hang on.
Mm-hmm.
You want to kind of get really close. This same technique will work if I were to grab you here.
Okay.
Right? You want to grab that. Go and reach up. There you go. And press that against
okay.
you. So now, when I try
I'm
to pull your hair, exactly.
Oh my God.
It's a quick little technique.
That's actually freaky, but it's good to know. Okay, so that's trapping. We're going to come back a little bit later and do some more and talk about kids and things like that and their safety. So that was very informative and helpful. So now we're going to head over and talk to our new host, Matthew. We're so excited that he's going to be part of it. And welcome, Matthew. Have fun.
Hi, my name is Matthew here. So I'm with Mark Christinger. Welcome to Shaw TV.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
It's good to see you once again. 2013 was a great year for Mark. He released two CDs, did two Eastern Canadian tours, played 131 shows. And is nominated for a Vancouver Island Music Award. Mark, you grew up in Quebec and have traveled to many different places. What brought you to Vancouver Island?
Oh, actually, it was because of a trip I took when I was playing Music West. I don't even know if they do that festival out here anymore, but I was on tour in the early 90s, and we came out to Vancouver Island. And we played at Harpo's down in Victoria.
Awesome.
And that's a long time ago. And then I took a trip out to Tofino. And by the time I got out to Tofino, I had decided that one day I need to move here.
Yeah, it's a beautiful place.
Yeah, man.
I know I wouldn't want to live anywhere else, right?
It's certainly a nice place.
Yeah, it's nice and relaxed. And what was your first song that you ever wrote?
The first song I ever wrote was a song called Katie when I was in seventh grade. And it was about a girl I really liked named Katie.
Awesome.
Yeah, and then I wrote the next song was a song called Let's Just Be Friends. And that that song was just about the same girl.
that's wonderful.
Yeah.
And it brought you to where you're standing now, right?
Yeah.
Like that's cool. Where exactly do you play?
These days, I primarily play on Vancouver Island, the Sunshine Coast, the Lower Mainland. I go up to Whistler a little bit and play, and I also do two tours of Eastern Canada a year.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's cool. So you travel quite a bit, eh?
I'm on the road a lot, but you have to be if you want to play about 130 shows a year, 140 shows a year. Yeah.
And it gets pretty going.
Mm-hmm.
And you were nominated for a song, right? In Love with a Liar.
Yeah, Best Rock Song, I guess. And those awards are coming up March. The award ceremony is coming up March 22nd at the Presbyterian Church, I believe, in Victoria. So get your tickets, folks, and come and come and see us do our thing down there and win some awards. Hopefully, maybe I'll win, eh?
Yeah, well, that's fantastic. Good luck to you. And so people can come and see this, so they can get to know more about you. Where can they find you?
These days, if you want to get to know more about what's happening, you can go to markchrissinger.com, and I've got 24 songs you can download for free there, plus you've got all my tour dates and videos. I play a lot in the Nanaimo area, And I just suggest that people go there to find out everything. And it's just markchrissinger.com. Yeah.
Well, that's fantastic. And I do want to thank you for coming to the show. And we'll throw to the song, In Love with a Liar.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
Right. Yeah, it doesn't get much more blues than this. In Love with a Liar. Well, I'm working so hard to try and figure out your ways, but chasing you around town is a game I don't wanna play. Being hard to get usually gets to being too late. Well, I don't understand it, and I'm tired of trying. I don't know why I'm in love with a liar. Well, my friends all say you're fooling around with someone new. I gotta shake my head, 'cause I feel like such a fool. After all we got going on, why you gotta be so cruel? Well, I don't understand it. You know I've been trying. I don't know why I'm in love with a liar. Well, it's hard to have any faith in love when every time it brings me down, yeah. It brings me down. It's time to move along, forget about what we used to have. I'd be out of my mind to give you a second chance, but I'm hooked on a pain that makes me want you so bad. Oh, I got a feeling for you now, I just can't deny it. I don't know why I'm in love with a liar. Yeah, I don't understand it, why I'm still trying. I don't know why I'm in love with a liar. I'm in love with a liar. I'm in love with a liar, yeah.
Thanks, Mark. I feel your pain. And from that topic to a completely different topic, February is we are going to be celebrating Black History Month again. And this is the 14th year for you. This is Shalima Gant, and you are the founder and president of the Nanaimo African Heritage Society.
Yes.
And so this is, you've been at this for quite some time.
Yeah, that's right. 14 years we're celebrating here in Nanaimo. Mm-hmm. It's known all around the world, Black History Month. And here in Nanaimo, we celebrate it with a big bang, as we usually do. We have 5-6 different events that we put on throughout the year, throughout the month. And
we have them here. And we actually have one of the performers.
That's right.
That's going to be part of the Bob Marley Legends of Reggae concert, I believe.
Yeah, celebrating Bob Marley's birthday. Yes. And
so I'm just going to introduce Aiden, mm-hmm. Ale Kopis, and your stage name is, tell me what your stage name is.
Adisa.
Okay.
Stage name's Adisa.
There you go. So we see you on the poster here. I'm just going to put the poster up because we have got a lot of different things going on during the month of February. So I'd like you to tell me a little bit about what's going to be happening.
Well, as you said, Adisa will be playing for the reggae concert. We do have our opening ceremony that's at the downtown Harborfront Library. That's where the mayor and the proclamation is given to us to declare Black History Month here in Nanaimo. And we move on to our tribute to Bob Marley and the great legends of reggae. Adisa's group will be starting off with some hip-hop music, and some wonderful artists, and we're having mainly Marley and the Planet Reggae on that one. And we move on down, and that is on the 7th of February. Mm-hmm. And we move on down to the 9th of February, which is a gospel concert.
Nice.
Featuring Gina Williams, who's
a
fantastic artist.
Yeah, I haven't heard of Gina Williams.
She's a very accomplished young lady. She's traveled all around the world. She sings in several different languages. And I'm looking so forward to hearing her gospel and some of her jazz. And we are doing an homage to some of the great lady singers.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, so there'll be 5 or 6 singers at the Brecon United Church on February the 9th. And then we move up to our wrap up, which is our grand finale. And once again, we'll bring in back the great Ezra Kazera, which always gets people dancing.
Afro Circus.
Yes, and there's the Afro Circus.
And can you tell me what the second person's name is, because I'll never pronounce that.
Is that Ezra Kazera and the...
Kabula.
Yes. The names are a little tricky, but
anyway.
Wonderful entertainers. And please come out and invite the community and
that's a dinner and
everybody
a dance.
To come. That's a dinner and a dance.
Mm-hmm.
That will be at the Nanaimo Golf Club.
Okay,
so that's our
TBA.
Wrap up.
Mm-hmm. So actually it's the Nanaimo Golf Club is the TBA. Okay.
Yeah, TBA. I'm kind of confused on that one.
Well, we've just
to be announced. To be announced. I just announced it.
That was
I did it.
The big announcement right here.
That was
the
big announcement. We did it. Oh, we got it out there.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. You heard it here, folks.
Yeah.
So we've got lots of things going on during the month of February, mm-hmm. and this is a time when we can actually really celebrate the awareness of what you've been through.
One of the things that we notice in our community that is very culturally diverse, and mm-hmm. so the Black pioneers have been here since the 1800s and beyond, and so we just want the people to come out and celebrate and embrace another culture mm-hmm. that has played a homage to our pattern and our great diversity
which people
community.
Aren't always aware of.
And people not always aware of all the history that we have here right on the island, right here in Nanaimo.
Yeah,
so we invite people to come out and learn more about the culture.
Right, and dance.
And dance.
And sing.
And have good food.
Uh-huh.
I love food.
That's,
yes.
That's great. So
you've got to have the food.
You've got a variety of things that are happening.
Yes.
So Aiden's going to be we're going to hear a little bit of
yes.
his music so that we can see what kind of a treat we're going to be having.
Yes.
On the 7th,
he's yes.
going to be performing.
Ready to put our dancing shoes on for sure.
Okay. Well, I think that what we're going to do is we're going to have you move out into the center. If anyone wants to find out any anything more about Black History Month, they can actually go to...
They could go to the website, which we're still working on. It's always a constant to work in progress. But it's the Nanaimo African Heritage, www.nanaimoafricanheritagesociety. Or, of course, call our office, which is 250-729-9332.
Which is coming up on the
screen. If you want to get more tickets, you can go to Fascinating Rhythm and or call our office.
Great.
Yes.
Well, there's lots of ways to get in touch with you.
Yeah.
And here's just a little sample of what you're going to be hearing on the 7th of February.
Awesome.
Spit, spin it down my mental corridor with a sense of casualness. I cannot fasten the thought until I feel my abdomen lift. As I breathe deep, it's easy to feel the healing well, peacefully dreaming the evening away, building myself as a leader. I'm seeking peace for my people and I ain't never leaving. But it's hard to make your mark when you ain't dead unless you breathing. You ain't really dead unless you breathing. I'm reversing turns of events, pulling levers, and then I'm leaving. Well, easily sequencing these seamless rhymes onto an easel. Then after that, on a needle, just so I can feel them deeper. I can feel my soul underneath my skin, but on the daily, society tells me to keep it within. All alone on my flow, enable the lock to my door. No attention is paid to those who expose every drug. This is mind power. This is for my people. Seconds, minutes, hours, won't stop until we're equal. Be aware what you divide, because one day you will hide and need someone to say it's okay because we're unified. Take a firm fist and raise it in the air. You will learn this, be sure to come prepared. Be aware what you divide, because one day you will hide and need someone to say it's okay because we're unified. This is mind power, this is for my people. Seconds, minutes, hours, won't stop until we're equal. Be aware what you divide, because one day you will lie and need someone to say it's okay because we're unified. Take a firm fist and raise it in the air. You will learn this, be sure to come prepared. Be aware what you divide, because one day you will lie and need someone to say it's okay because we're unified.
Wow, thanks Adisa, thank you so much. That was amazing. One of my New Year's resolutions is to dance more, so I will be definitely going out and checking out some of the Black History Month. So we are now back. We are going to be talking to Raven and his wee young man. This is Wyatt. Hi, Wyatt.
Hi.
We're going to talk a little bit more about the self-defense. So no matter what age, you're what, eight?
Eight.
Yeah, it's important to know some self-defense techniques. And we want people to leave here and any classes and stuff that you do feeling empowered, not scared. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So that's one of the things. I know when we just did that last segment, when we were off, I said, I feel like I was in charge there. It wasn't scared. I felt like I was in charge. And that's what you want people to feel. Right. Good.
That's where you want to be. Because if you're not afraid, then you won't panic. You keep your breath down. You'll be able to outlast your opponent, hopefully.
Think better.
And think better. Absolutely. Right. Okay. Make better decisions at that point.
Okay. So you have classes that you do up in Parksville, and you also teach at different places. You go to different places when they ask you to come, right?
I do, yes.
Great. So I know, because personally, I have signed my kids up for your self-defense class in February. Can you tell me a little bit about that class for kids?
It's going to be on the 22nd. It's from ages 5 to 15. We're going to do it in two different segments.
Right.
We're going to have one for the younger kids. This is basically for them to have some tools against a predator attack. And what I mean is pedophiles, that sort of thing, abduction. All the scary,
yes.
The scary monsters that we as parents are frighten us, paralyze us. Yes. So
we're going to do a little bit of Wyatt's going to be our target, and he's going to show us some of the techniques that you've taught him, right?
Absolutely.
I'll go, Wyatt.
Excellent. These techniques come from my Sheehan, Steve Hisco from Chilliwack. Give him a little. Cues for that, yay. And this basically, if I was to try and take this young man from his parents or get him separated wherever I find him, then I'm going to try and lead him away. Of course, in this case, I wouldn't be his dad, right? So I'm going to try and take you away from your parents. And what are you going to do? And what are we screaming? What do we say?
You're not my dad.
Oh, and so he's screaming,
what do we do?
You're not my dad.
We say that over and over again, right?
You're not my dad. You're not my dad.
Okay, leave my shoelaces alone for this demonstration. He likes to do my shoelaces. What happens here at this point is he's got my legs trapped.
Right.
Again, we're on that theme for that. He should be yelling, making a lot of noise, which is going to attract attention, saying, not my dad, not my dad, this is not my parent, because it's important for you to know that this isn't my son. This isn't me having a actually right now it is me having a disciplinary problem. But in the mall or in the shopping centers, it's you people that are out and about that see this sort of thing and you go, geez, should I get involved or shouldn't I? And you don't want to get involved with another parent's situation. So if he's saying this isn't my parent, that's a cue for you to get involved.
Yeah.
We were actually doing this demonstration at Kids Fest in Parksville 2 years ago, and a lady stopped her stroller and came over and was pulling people over to help the kids, thinking that it was an actual event. So he's usually a better actor than this.
Wyatt, you're awesome. You know, I'm really excited because this stuff is important, and I really, really recommend people come and check you out. Learn more. Get your kids empowered. Be empowered yourself no matter what age you are. Be engaged, hence engaged fitness, and be part of it. And when you do see a situation, step in. Please, please, please step in. That's what's really important. That's what builds community.
It does.
Yeah. Look at that. I was just on my soapbox there, right in there. So,
okay,
no, and thank you, Wyatt. That was awesome. So, February 22nd, more classes are coming up.
Yes.
Okay, that's great. And I think, are you going to come in and hang out there, Mr. Matt?
Nothing indeed. Yeah, exactly.
Are you going to hang out?
Apparently, I'm also.
What do you say?
He's not my son! He's not my son! He's not my son! He's not my son!
He's not your dad.
All right. So as you can see, if you do try to make an escape route at this point, it is pretty much impossible with any sort of speed whatsoever. So before I actually do fall on my forehead, I'm going to try to back up a little bit.
Okay.
And I'm going to hit Kim accidentally. So now Kim's going to try to self-defense for
okay,
me
right.
now, too. And I'll say, thank you so much for coming to the show.
Thank
much
you.
Appreciate it. I do have one really quick question for you. We're talking obviously about, in terms of self-defense, some of the physical things you can do. What about a mental sort of thing? What do you think about if someone is approaching you aggressively?
Thanks for asking. This is much like a fire drill. It's something that you want to be prepared for. So it's good for you to get a mental idea of what it is you're going to do when you're in that situation, if it does happen, so you don't panic for that. So it's good to just kind of run through it mentally. You know, what would I do? What would I do if somebody tried to put me in their car, or put me in a van, or take a hold of me, or, you know, jump me in these situations? So, yeah, it's a great idea to mentally roll through it.
Yeah, perfect. All right. Well, thank you so much. And again, thanks for coming to the show. Thanks, Kim, for taking on this segment.
Thank
you.
My shoe's untied. Yes, my shoe is untied. Look at that. Look at that. Yeah, look at that. Just embarrassing right now. All right. Well, I'll lace them up in a bit. Again, it's also great to have, a practitioner of jiu-jitsu in here. I know for myself, I'm usually a practitioner of nibs and jujubes. Not quite as healthy. And especially on Boxing Day, you know, when you have that thing there. And you cannot feed jujubes, though, to your dog, such as my dog, who is a Rottweiler. A quick story about my man Todd Jones, who's directing the show right now. He's regular viewers of the show know he's a huge fan of the Toronto Maple Leafs, one of his favorite players. Huge fan of the Toronto Maple Leafs. He's a big fan of Ty Domi. And back when Todd was a kid watching Ty play, and Ty would get in a fight, right, speaking of self-defense, and he would lose, Todd would write a letter, and he would send Ty condolences. Ty condolences. You never lie. I tell you, well, boy, our Shaw TV lawyer is going to sumo plaintiffs if these jokes get worse, especially if the plaintiffs, you know, are beautiful, you know, like a Barbie doll or a Ken doll. And like when Mr. T was actually in that disaster movie featuring that oversized gorilla, you know, said, I pity the fool. I pity the King Kong fool. Kung Fu. All right, moving along. Anyhow, last thing I'll say is I actually bought a painting just the other day from the play-by-play voice of the Nanaimo Clippers. I'm definitely a fan of Dan Martial Arts. And martial arts. Oh, wow, this is just getting worse and worse. So I'm going to quickly wrap up the show now. You can find videos and photos of the show on our Facebook page at facebook.com/theshowonshaw, as well as on the Shaw TV Central Vancouver Island YouTube page, as if you're going to go there now after that run of jokes. I do want to send a big thank you to all of our guests, our volunteer staff, in front of the camera and in behind the scenes. And if you do have a good story idea or you want to be featured on the show, drop an email to our producer, Melissa Hall. Her email address is melissa.hall@sjrb.ca.
Day. All right, so mercifully coming near the end, we're going to have one more song, some great stuff from Mark Christinger, and the song we're going to hear is entitled Caught in the Middle. So here you go, Mark Christinger, and thank you so much for watching the show right here on Shaw TV.
Talking to myself in the middle of the night, tossing and turning cause it don't feel right. I'm caught in the middle and I like it very little. I'm caught in the middle, baby, you've been gone too long. Was it something I did? Was it something I said? Was it some kind of signal that went unread? I'm caught in the middle, we're in some kind of pickle. I'm caught in the middle, and baby, you've been gone too long. I've been thinking about you every single night and day. I don't even know why you had to go away. I've been pulling my hair out, wondering where you're gone. How could something feel so good, then feel so damn wrong? Well, people been asking where you can be found. I just keep on telling them you ain't around. I've been caught in the middle, like a cat and a fiddle. I've been caught in the middle, baby, you've been gone too long. I've been thinking about you every single night and day. I don't even know why you had to go away. I've been pulling my hair out, wondering where you're gone. How could something feel so good, then feel so damn wrong? Well, come back, baby, I wish you would, cause this old feeling don't feel too good. I've been caught in the middle, like a cat and a fiddle. I've been caught in the middle, baby, you've been gone too long. Yes, I've been caught in the middle, baby, I've been gone too long. Well, I've been caught in the middle, baby, you've been gone too long. Yes, indeed.